Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is the one and only SiloMan coming from a launch control center of a former Atlas F intercontinental ballistic missile site outside of Roswell, New Mexico, USA. In the next 13 minutes, you're going to see some of the exterior photographs taken over the last 20 years. The one that you see here is when we're having some testing done. They're taking a soil sample because we're having a tower, a communication tower put in here very near the entryway. In this photograph, this large amount of dirt that you see around was the excavation from the launch control center. In the background there was the septic tank and distribution box. Here's what we call the silo cap area. And as you're looking across, you can see we're extending this parking area out a little further. So we're using some dirt that was originally used of the hill of dirt that was from the excavation of the original water tanks. And you can see there the water treatment facility in the background. And then you can see the septic tank and the distribution box. There's another picture looking towards the west. And coming back across, you can see where we're backfilling quite a bit of what's going on. You can see where the tower was just put in. Right there's the entryway. You can see the communication manhole. This is the air exhaust shaft to the launch control center. There is the entryway. We're backfilling again. If you remember some of those earlier photographs, you saw all that dirt removed. That's where five tanks were located that held 92,000 gallons worth of water while the site was in operation. Here was that giant pit area where those tanks originally were. That is the top of the escape shaft that's been covered up. You can see again, we're going through and we're just simply backfilling all of this and then of course leveling it. See the guide wire coming down from the tank. We're right here, we're looking towards the west. We're removing quite a bit of the mesquite and all the brush. Some of the remnants of the salvaged equipment that came out of the control center and the silo. And here we're going along just simply grading the dirt as we're moving it out, increasing the area that park that we're going to be parking in. Right there you can see the portion of the upper level of the control center. And that steel line coming in is going to what we call the sewer manhole. Some of the lines that originally ran into the control center. You can see there in the distance, you've got the air exhaust shaft, the entryway, and then the escape shaft, and the communication manhole. You can see where the new tower is located. You can see as the control center goes on around. Square box in the back was the manifold that you can see there on the left of the photograph for the water tanks. That unit there that you're looking at looks like a concrete T. Was the culminator site base for the culminator, which was in essence, it allowed the guidance system of the Atlas F missile to take its position off of the North Star Polaris. Here's the silo cap area, and of course the pickup and the trailer that we haul the backhoe out on. And we just used a baby backhoe, as you can tell in this. There again is part of the control center. Those walls are typically 3 to 5 feet thick, same with the ceiling. Looking across as it's panning, you can see the hill and the dirt of dirt in the back that was used. And there the opening is too. You can start to see where we're backfilling in. Some of those lines that you see at the bottom of the entryway, we're going ahead and cutting them, clearing them out, and then we're going to sleeve them and bring them up to different locations closer to the surface and then mark them. And what they are for is that when we want to gain entry through different areas of the upper level of the control center, we have a clear path to do that. You can see where we're cutting off some of these lines and rerouting them. That's looking at the culminator tube that's coming up to the concrete. And there we're simply doing some work down there at the bottom. At one point, we are going to go down there and dig down exactly 26 feet The reason being is the remnants of the 4-inch steel line that was originally attached to the last water tank that then you're going to see on the inside goes to a 6-inch opening in the utility tunnel that provided water to the silo. This here is the communication manhole. The line that you see broken off and to the right was originally the line that went to a telephone pole that had phone service. And you can see some of the different lines as we're coming around the control center. You can see quite a few of those large number 4 wires there. That originally was for the TIPSI, which was an antenna system that was put in. There was only about 4 of our original 12 sites that this was put in. And they were put in at the very last days of the 579. Now this round piece of concrete that with cement on top that you see in the background, that's the HF antenna silo. There was a 105-foot retractable antenna based on frequency that was underground for communication for the site. This long pipe that you see here was probably one of the last of the original vents for one of the long tanks of the 92,000 gallons worth of water. And here again, you can see those number of lines that were used for that, that went all around the property for the TIPSI antenna. And some of the dirt work that we're doing, trying to clear. We're changing a bit of the grading at this point because we're increasing the size of the what we're going to call the area surrounding the entryway. And you can see it here. And here's where we're sleeving some of the lines coming up. These 4-inch lines that you see are coming out of the communication manhole. We're making it very easy, bringing them up within about a foot of the surface. So when we need to simply bring something in underground, we can. It's a matter of just digging down and it's there. We don't have to go down the full 6 or 8 feet. We're just making it easier for ourselves. And again, some of the brush and mesquite that we're trying to clear out of the way. Again, some of those lines that we're cutting and then we're going to be sleeving them that's on the east side of the entryway. You can see where we're backfilling. Again, that was the rectangular piece that was used for the manifold for the water tanks. We've created a small little road there for the backup. We're hauling in a portable 500 gallon water tank, and what we're doing is we're flushing the comm manhole of all the dirt and muck. It's been left open for really 50 years. At this point, we're cutting some of those lower lines that are coming out of the comm manhole, and we're going to be sleeving them. We're cutting steel plate, the new manhole covers that we're using, and you can see some of the backfill up against the culminator site pad. You can see the entryway and the door, which the kids have cut holes in it. You can see us there, we're still working down there coming out of the comm manhole. What you're seeing right here was originally a test well put in by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, the Albuquerque District, to test on the water table. And there again, you can see the tower in the background. There's the comm manhole. You'll see these little pads that originally carried a light base. And two, you can see how nice we're going to start grading this all the way out. You may notice in one of the first few photographs you saw this section how nice it was, and then we had the fence around it. Again, this is inside of that comm manhole. So you can see how much muck was in there that we got rid of. Here, of course, you can start to tell how we're moving around with the pad. And we've extended out quite a ways. We have the door off the entryway. We'll be making a new custom door. And then there you can see the dent that we're making with the back of the hill of dirt. That's what we call the UHF antenna, the ultra high frequency antenna base. It was a small torpedo antenna that was used. What we'll be using eventually this for is the pad for the emergency generator. It was the old door, the air exhaust shaft. Again, air exhaust shaft, there's the entryway. So we're leveling this out, and we'll start to, then we'll allow it to settle. You can see we've got our job. The little pad that you see in the background, that's for the water cooling tower originally, and then way in the back were the two air washers for level one of the silo. Here's some of the mesquite. This concrete unit is over what we call the fill-in vent shaft. This was simply the well casing for a test well that was put down. Here again, you've got the UHF antenna base. We're about to flood it so we can flush that line. And there we're sleeving those lines that we showed you earlier coming on the east side of the entryway. Of course, it seemed like every time that we put no trespassing, more of the kids got in and created more of the graffiti, so. And there again, you can see the culminator site tube base. And we're gonna go ahead and flush. We got the water tank you can see on the back of the trailer. And we're gonna flush those temporary lines coming in from the east side of the entryway. Those lines come in, and I'll be showing you in different photographs when we're on the upper level of the control center. And there you can see the antenna silo in the back. And again, some of the area that we're digging out. Some of the mesquite, wow. I mean, some of that had to be 50 years old. And it is tough. Right there is the very top of the antenna silo. It goes down 30 feet. It's got its own, it was in the little, and I say little, it wasn't little, but the retractable antenna. Here's the very bottom of the UHF, and that round UHF antenna base. In fact, that line that goes down through there is the lane which we ran the alternate power coming from the backup generator. The original main gate was roughly in here. We just put up a temporary a cable in which to try to keep the people out of the place, and left that line of mesquite for the time being till we got it all cleared up. You can see we're starting to create piles of the mesquite as we go through. We had two tractors. We had an old Ford 9N or 8N, and then of course we had the backup. That's the original access road. Well, again, I'd like to thank everybody. I hope you've learned something and enjoyed this. If you would, please subscribe, hit that bell, and let us know. And you'll be in line for new videos that we're bringing out. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comment section. Love to hear from you. And thank you again.